A blessed day, Faith family. For our faith aid, let me share to you about God's grace. Let us pray. Father, we ask you to bless this time for your word. We thank you, Lord, that we will understand your grace more and more. In Jesus' name, amen. God's grace is fullness to man's emptiness. God's grace is God's power at work in us and through us, where the weak become strong, every needs are provided, impossible becomes possible. It is the power of God at work in every situation in the lives of every mankind in order to accomplish God's purpose and plans. And it is the secret behind overcoming every obstacles in life. But now, let's talk about what God wants to do over your life and my life by His grace. He wants to bring in His fullness into our lives because He is the God of fullness. In the book of John, chapter 15, verse 5, Jesus said, "I am the vine, you are the branches. Those who remain in me and I in them will produce much fruit. For apart from me, you can do nothing." Without Jesus, we are empty. In John 10:10, "A thief has only one thing in mind. He wants to steal, slaughter, and destroy. But I have come to give you everything in abundance, more than you expect, life in its fullness until you overflow." The devil is at work to make us empty. The little we have, the devil is eagerly wanting to kill, steal, and even destroy. So how did God start to bring in His fullness to the emptiness of man? Number one, He sent Jesus to be born into this physical world. The Word became flesh in John chapter 1 and verse 14. Number two, He sent Jesus to let us know that we are no longer alone in the battles of life, because He is with us. In Matthew chapter 1, verse 23, "And a virgin shall conceive and shall bear a son, and you shall call his name Emmanuel," meaning God with us. We are never alone in the battles of life because Jesus is with us. That He promised to us His ever-abiding presence. Number three, He sent Jesus in order to fill every area of emptiness with His fullness, because in Christ Jesus we are complete. In Christ we receive fullness in Colossians 2, 9 to 10, "For He is the complete fullness of deity living in human form. And our own completeness is now found in Him. We are completely filled with God as Christ's fullness overflows within us." What God wants to do right now in your life is He wants to hold everything together in our lives, because He is before all things, and in Him all things hold together in Colossians 1, 17. And He wants to bring in new and wonderful things. In 2 Corinthians 5, 17, "Therefore, if anyone is in Christ, the new creation has come, the old is gone, the new is here." And God wants to fill whatever is lacking in us. Colossians 2, 9 to 10, "For He is the complete fullness," let me say it again, "complete fullness of deity living in human form. And our own completeness is now found in Him. We are completely filled with God as Christ's fullness overflows within us. In Christ we are complete, and in Christ we receive fullness." And He wants to bring in His fullness into our lives because He is the God of fullness. God's grace is His fullness, and He wants to pour them out to every place of emptiness into your life and into my life. So Jesus is the complete expression of God's grace to mankind. His finished work at the cross opened up the floodgates of God's grace to everyone and to every area of needs you may have and I may have. If we will acknowledge our own emptiness, His grace is readily available to fill us up. So let us allow Him to hold everything together in our lives. As we surrender unto Him things that we cannot understand, things that we cannot control, and allow Him to bring in new and wonderful things, as we lay down before Him things of the old, things that we should have let go of, like hurts, fears, regrets, disappointments, discouragement, just allow Him to bring in new and wonderful things. And thirdly,
He wants, allow Him to fill whatever is lacking in us. As we acknowledge our area of emptiness, the fullness of His grace will flow and fill us, my dear brothers and sisters. Let us come before the Lord in prayer. Father, we acknowledge our own emptiness. To my dear brothers and sisters, Lord, You know specifically. Father God, we lay it down before You, Lord, and we ask the fullness of Your grace, Lord, when You sacrificed Your life and died at the cross, Lord, the floodgates of Your grace was open. And Lord, we access on the availability of that grace right now, O God, to that area of needs. Fill it up, Lord. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. God bless everyone. Thank you so much.